Now, welcome to 1 hour personal and corporate worship this glorious Sunday. God bless you for joining us. Invite a friend, a family member to be part of this worship session to start our week. Our divine mandate as a ministry is to preach God's word to the lost through God-inspired music, edify believers through scripturally sound music, raise and deploy seasoned ministers of God in music through service. Your being here is not by chance, but carefully orchestrated by God for your spiritual growth and development into an active believer in kingdom service. As you fellowship and serve with us at Glow Music, God will meet your every need and godly desire according to his word in Psalm 37, verse 4, which says, "Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart." Amen.
Amen.
God bless you for joining us. Once again, before we go into worship, we're going to study the word of God briefly. Speak to the Lord right now concerning the word that is coming, that he gives you a deeper understanding, revelation from this word to be able to worship him the way you ought to. Lord, we come before you once again this evening to learn of you. We are only privileged to be in your presence this evening. We pray that you speak to our hearts. Help us to serve you the way you want us to in the name of Jesus. Reveal to us deep secrets from your word. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You are welcome again. This is Sunday worship hour. And as you know, it's our covenant with God to start our week with 1 hour singing of songs to the glory of his name. As we sing songs of worship unto the Lord, as I always say, even if you're an instrumentalist, it's not the time to play the instrument, but it's a time to sing. Let your voice be heard. And sing the songs from your heart in worship to the Lord. As our custom, as we study the word of God to set the focus right so that we can worship with the right perspective. We've been looking at a heart of worship. I think this would be the fifth session. And the sub-theme of it is three important things God requires from us. And this would be about the fourth time that we are looking at three important things God requires from us. The key scripture is in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 19. It shall be, if thou do at all forget the Lord thy God and walk after other gods and serve them and worship them, I testify against you this day that ye shall surely perish. So we are not supposed to walk after other gods. We are not supposed to serve other gods. And we are not supposed to worship other gods. We've looked at walking with God. We've looked at serving God, and we are on the third point, which is worship. Recapping from our last session, we established the truth that, or we discovered the truth that Satan covets our worship, but we must only worship God through Christ Jesus, or God through Jesus Christ. And we looked at Matthew chapter 4, verse 10. Where Satan took Jesus up to a high place, and then he said, he asked Jesus to worship him, but Jesus answered unto him in verse 10 of Matthew 4, "Get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and in him only shalt thou serve." So we must worship God alone through Christ Jesus in spirit and in truth. According to John 4:23, that was the second thing we looked at. "But the hour cometh, and now is when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. for the Father seeketh such to worship him. So worship only God through Jesus Christ, and then worship in spirit and in truth. We are forbidden to worship any other God but our God. So we also looked at, do not worship traditional gods, and that the gods we shouldn't worship. The first one was, do not worship traditional gods, talking about gods of the family, of the nation, of an organization, etc. I entreat you to listen to worship hour from our previous sessions. Exodus 34:14, for thou shalt worship no other God, for the Lord whose name is jealous is a jealous God. And we also looked at Matthew 15:6. Thus have you made the commandment of God none effect by your tradition. So don't we must let go of our traditions which tie us to worshiping traditional gods. We thank God for his deliverance in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Today we are looking at, do not worship rulers, kings, and earthly authorities, which are a form of, they are also forms of gods. Do not worship rulers, kings, and earthly authorities. We are reading Daniel chapter 3, verse 1. It's quite lengthy, but we'll take it. Nebuchadnezzar the king made an image of gold whose height was 80. Okay, so before we read, we know the story of Daniel and his friends who were carried away to Babylon. They were carried away to Babylon when they were young boys. And now this is a story, one of the things that happened when they were in Babylon. Nebuchadnezzar the king made an image of gold whose height was 80 cubits and the breadth thereof 6 cubits. He set it up in the plain of Dura in the province of Babylon. So that's 90 feet tall and 9 feet wide. 90 feet tall and 9 feet wide. From the floor to the roof, a normal room, the roof, that should be about 8 feet. So it should give you a fair idea, 9 feet. So the width was 9 feet, and then 10 times that. So you can imagine the height. That should be about an 11-story building. That was the height of the statue. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king sent to gather together the princes, the governors, and the captains, the judges, the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs, wow, and all the rulers of the provinces to come to the dedication of the image which Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up for dedication or launching. Then Daniel 3:3, then the princes, the governors and captains, the judges, the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs, even the sheriffs, that's everybody, everybody important, and all the rulers of the provinces were gathered together unto the dedication of the image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up, and they stood before the image that Nebuchadnezzar had set up. This is more than outdooring. Then a herald cried aloud, to you it is commanded, O people, nations, and languages, that at what time ye hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, dulcimer, and all kinds of music, ye fall down and worship the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. Wow. And the statue was made of gold. The man was rich. A very great kingdom. And whoso falleth not down and worshipeth shall the same hour be cast into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. Now they have a policy added. Wow. Therefore, at that time, when all the people heard the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, and all kinds of music, all the people, the nations, and the languages fell down and worshiped the gold image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. Because if you don't fall down, you are going to the burning fiery furnace. So why wouldn't they fall down? There are certain Jews whom thou has set. Okay, so we move to verse 12, and something happened. So there were people who carried this report to the king, and this was the report they sent to him. There are certain Jews whom thou hast set over the affairs of the province of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, have not regarded thee. They serve not thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar, in his rage and fury, commanded to bring Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Then they brought these men before the king. Nebuchadnezzar spake and said unto them, Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Do not ye serve my gods, nor worship the golden image which I have set up? Now, if ye be ready that at what time ye hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, and dulcimer, and all kinds of music, ye fall down and worship the image which I have made, well, but if ye worship not, ye shall be cast the same hour into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. Who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hand? So he was reminding them about the punishment for not worshiping his image. And he said, if you don't do it, who can deliver you? Now, even in our day, our nations, which nation in our time can set up a golden statue which is 9 feet by 90 feet? Just gold. Wow. So the kingdom of Nebuchadnezzar, the Babylonian kingdom, it was a mighty kingdom those times. And here's the king talking to our brothers. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, Oh, Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. If it be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thy hand, O king. But if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. That is serious. Then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and the form of his visage was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore he spake, and he commanded that they should hit the furnace 17 times more than it was wont to be hit. And he commanded the most mighty men that were in his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and to cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Then these men were bound in their coats, their hosen and their hats and their other garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Therefore, because the king's commandment was urgent and the furnace exceeding hot, the flame of the fire slew those men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. It means they didn't put on fire, you know, fire equipment to even protect themselves, because the king was angry and it was urgent. So in their bids to do his bidding, they even got destroyed. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished, and rose up in haste and spake and said unto his counselors, Did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? They answered and said unto the king, True, O king. He answered and said, Lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no heads. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. Wow. Then Nebuchadnezzar came near to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace, and spake and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, ye servants of the Most High God, come forth and come hither. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth of the midst of the fire, and the princes, governors, and captains, and the king's counselors, being gathered together, saw these men upon whose bodies the fire had no power, nor was an hair of their head singed. Is it singed? Neither were their coats changed. Wow, I like their account. Their hair was untouched. The coats that they went to gather to bind them with, so that it would even burn them more, their coats were not changed. Nor the smell of fire had passed on them. You couldn't even smell the fire on them, like people who had been in fire. Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said, Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who had sent his angel and delivered his servants that trusted in him, and have changed the king's word and yielded their bodies, that they might not serve nor worship any god except their own God. Therefore, I make a decree that every people, nation, and language which speak anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut in pieces, and their houses shall be made a dunghill, because there is no God that can deliver after this sort. Then the king promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the province of Babylon. Because of time, we will look at some keynotes another time. But today, what Nebuchadnezzar declared, there is no other truth apart from it. There is no other God that can deliver like this kind. Like this kind God. There's no other God that can deliver like this kind. Like our God. God will defend every true worshiper.
Amen.
The king, you could see that the king somehow loved or liked these boys, but because they openly defied his command and they had been reported, he didn't immediately kill them. He gave them another opportunity, reminding them, and they said, King, even if our God won't rescue us, we still won't bow to your statue. Do not worship earthly kings, authorities. Do not worship them. Do not worship rulers, earthly rulers, kings, and authorities. Earthly rulers, kings, and authorities. Worship the one and only true God who can deliver you from the fiery furnace. In our day, there are families that are bound spiritually, and it's because they are the members of the family tend to worship earthly authorities instead of worshiping the one and only true God. Because of not serving the Lord and choosing to serve men, because of what we would get, there are many lives that have been lost, many destinies buried without seeing the light of day, many destinies never fulfilled, people in the graves who never fulfilled what God wanted them to do because of pleasing earthly authorities. My prayer is that today, any fiery furnace, any judgment, like Nebuchadnezzar had issued judgment upon these boys because of defying earthly authorities and choosing to stand with the one and only true living God. That judgment that came upon them, the Lord delivered them. My prayer is that the Lord would deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
For every time that you stand with God, may He show His mighty hand upon your life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And He said, and He promoted them. He warned those who reported them. And He said, if anybody does not or treats our God not right, He said that their houses will become a dunghill. And then He promoted the believers. Today, be a believer. Be a believer. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
Again, to thank the Lord for the opportunity to sing songs of worship to Him in the name of Jesus. Give the Lord thanks for the opportunity to sing songs of worship. Lord, we thank You for the opportunity to sing songs of worship to You in the name of Jesus. Thank You for this worship hour, and thank You for the opportunity to be able to sing to You from our hearts in the name of Jesus. To sing with a heart of worship, Lord, we thank You. Thank You for this opportunity. Thank You, Lord. We thank You, Lord, in Jesus' name. Pray right now, asking the Lord to forgive you of any known or nonsense. Ask the Lord to cleanse you with the blood of Jesus. As we know, the Bible says that if we confess our sins, He's faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from any form of unrighteousness. So pray to the Lord quietly right now, asking Him to forgive you and cleanse you. So right now, pray forgiving anyone who has offended you in any way right now. Release them from your heart. Say the prayer on the screen. I forgive anyone who has offended me in any way right now. I release them from my heart right now in the name of Jesus. Anyone who may have offended me that I've kept in my heart, Lord Jesus, help me to release them from my heart right now in the name of Jesus. I release them from my heart now. I release them from my heart now. I release them from my heart now in the name of Jesus. Lord, grant me the grace to release them from my heart now in the name of Jesus. Thank You, Lord. Thank You, Lord, for the release. In Jesus' name. Finally, pray. Saying, Father in heaven,
please accept my worship.
As I sing unto You.
Father in heaven.
Please accept my worship. As I sing unto You. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank God for this time in His presence. As we worship, just worship along with us. As you listen, as you watch, worship Jesus with us. Amen. Luke 4 verse 8. Jesus answered, it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve Him only. Amen. Pray for the grace to be able to serve God only. In Jesus' name. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Simple song, let's sing together. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God is my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Scripture we read above, we see that he is a great God, and he was always able to prove it to everyone who dared to challenge him. This is the God we serve.
Amen.
Just in a few seconds, lift him up. In which all-knowing, all-present, one without an end. Before time began, you were, and after time has ended, you will be. Thank you, Jesus. We have the opportunity to know you. We exalt you, King of Kings.
Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we worship you.
We give you all the glory. We exalt you this evening.
Hallelujah.
One crapona. One crapona. One crapona. One crapona. One crapona. Wine crampona to sewerati. Wine crampona. Wine crampona. Wine crampona. Wine crampona to sewerati.
John 15:5. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me ye can do nothing. Amen.
Amen.
Nyankopon,
Genesis chapter 5 verse 24. And Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This month, as we worship, we trust that he would enable us to walk with him.
Amen.
Like these fathers of the faith. Oh, let me walk with thee, my God, as Enoch walked in days of old. Place thou my trembling hand in thine, and sweet communion with me hold. In though the path I may not see, yet Jesus, let me walk with thee. May not Kachi, and Jesus led me walk. Oh, let, oh, let me walk with thee, my God, as Enoch walked in days of old. Place down.
Then Jesus spake unto them, saying, Then Jesus spake again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Amen.
Amen.
It's not.
Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me.
Amen.
Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. In a few seconds, just worship the name of the Lord. Lord, I worship you because when I walk with you, I'm not going to fall. I won't deviate. I won't fail.
Thank you, Jesus, that even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'm not fearing no evil, for you are with me. Lord, we worship your most holy name. You are worthy. We thank you, Jesus.
I give you glory.
Hallelujah.
So I want to walk with you every day, every way. I will walk with you, my Lord, every step of the way. I want to walk with you every day, every way. I will walk with you, my Lord, every step of the way. I cannot fail, I cannot drown, I cannot miss the way to go. I will not stumble, you hold my hand every step of the way. Oh, I cannot fail, I cannot drown, I cannot miss the way to go. I will not stumble, you hold my hand every step of the way.
This is a glow music song, and every time remember it, that you're gonna walk with God and you can't fail.
With you, I want to walk with you every day, every way. I will walk with you, my Lord, every step of the way. I want to walk with you.
I cannot fail, I cannot fail, I cannot.
stumble, you hold my hand every step of the way. I will trip ever, I will not stumble, you hold my hand every step of the way. One more time, I will and I will not stumble, you hold my hand every step of the way.
When the Lord holds your hand, you are guaranteed reaching where he wants you to go. And we serve a Lord in whom there is no shadow of turning. All his ways are right. Today you have the opportunity to have a restored relationship back to the maker of heaven and earth, the one who created us all. The I am that I am. And the way to him is through his Son, Jesus Christ, who paid the dear sacrifice that we should have suffered by dying in our place and rising again from death in victory, now having authority over death and the grave. That even after life on earth, you have access to eternal life through Christ Jesus. So today, please say these words after me. Lord Jesus, I admit that I'm a sinner. I cannot save myself. Today, I ask that please come into my heart, come into my life, be the Lord and Master over my life, every aspect of my life. Today, I hand over my decisions to you. I hand over every part of my life to you. I choose to walk with you each day of my life, and grant me your Holy Spirit that I can live a life that is pleasing unto you. I thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Amen.
Amen. If you just said this prayer, contact us via email info@glowministry.com or call or chat with us through 026-000-9090. Kindly pay attention to the announcements. We are glad that you could fellowship with us today. For all those who are here for the first time, and those who have not had the privilege to be around for some time, we say welcome. Our mandate as a ministry demands that we propagate God's word through music recordings and distribution, music outreach projects, and the raising and deploying of seasoned music ministers through service. We admonish you to participate in all activities so as to play a role in fulfilling this mandate, so that God also plays his role as a doing God in your life. Amen. Download scripturally sound gospel music from glowmusicrecords.com to edify your spirit. If you'd like to send offerings, tithes, and covenant seeds, you can do that using MTN Momo through 054-362-7478. Kindly share your prayer request with us as we believe the Lord for answered prayers. The link is glowmusicministry.com/prayer-request. Also, send your testimonies to glowmusicministry.com/testify. Please take note that we are fasting tomorrow from 6 a.m. to 12 p.m. to begin the week. Please join in this spiritual exercise. God bless you. Please be reminded of our Bethel Encounter Blessed Monday edition. Tomorrow at 12 p.m., join us, pray concerning issues that are related to music ministry. God bless you. God bless you for paying attention to the announcements.
Shall we share the grace?
The grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you for joining one more time. We'll meet at 12 p.m. prompt tomorrow. Shalom.